One of the most important parts of learning the bow hold is relaxation. You want your hands to be nice and relaxed. So before you start, put your bow on your lap and work on relaxing your hand. I like to pretend that my hand is in a bucket of water and I'm kind of swirling it around. So you want your wrist to be nice and relaxed, you want your fingers to be nice and relaxed, and you're kind of just swirling around like a tornado. So then you bring your hand out of the bucket and you kind of let the water drip off. And this is a very natural shape for the cello bow hold. Unlike the violin bow hold, which has more of a stance like this, the cello bow hold's a lot more relaxed. So then what you're gonna do, and your teacher will be able to help you with this as well, is with your relaxed bow hold, bring your bow up to your fingers and let your fingers just kind of drape over. One of the things that you wanna try and do is have your first finger on this little grip here in between the knuckles. And then your second finger will come close to the silver bit here next to the frog. Your third finger next to there, and you wanna actually put these two down. This is kind of like a unit. And then adding your pinky, okay? So nice and relaxed, okay? Let's try that again. So your hand's dripping, you bring your hand over, and each hand size is different too. So depending on if you've got larger hands or smaller hands, whatever feels comfortable for you, but your first finger on the grip, in between the knuckles, your second and third finger together, your second finger near the silver part, and then bringing your pinky down. So another difference between the violin and cello bow hold is that the pinky in the violin bow hold sits on top. For the cello, we're way more relaxed because our cello is positioned like this instead of on our shoulders. Our pinky hangs down a little bit. So once we've got that down, we need to figure out what to do with our thumb. And so our thumb is going to curve on the underside here, okay? So in between the frog and the grip, you can see kind of where the indent where my thumb goes. Your thumb is gonna go there on the tip of the thumb. Very, very, very important that you're on the tip and that your thumb doesn't slide through. So you have your fingers, they're nice and relaxed. You bring your thumb around so that it has a nice curve because you wanna be as relaxed as possible, and having a curved thumb will make that more relaxed.